After I covered the importance of visual design in my last video, I immediately got an idea of what to share next. So welcome to another episode of the UX Portfolio Series. In this video, I want to show you 5 sources to good portfolios that have fantastic visual design to study, learn, and get inspirations from.
Only 5 sources?
No, trust me, it's very unlikely that you can go through all the portfolios in those 5 sources. Well, in case you do and you iterate on your portfolio to raise the portfolio quality bar to that standard, you are pretty much guaranteed a UX internship or full-time job. Well, so let's get started and roll the intro. My name is Justine and I'm a designer working in Silicon Valley. The 5 sources that I'm about to show you will have well above average visual design, and some of them might actually have good or solid UX case studies. By going through a lot of them yourselves, you should get a very deep, visceral, and innate understanding of where the visual design or look and feel bar is and how a project should be presented. This should be a fairly quick but informative video, so without further ado, let's dive right into it. Number 1, awards with 3 W's. This source for sure is very visual and UI design driven. You can see a lot of different styles, from very clean UI to complex one that tends to be professional, a lot of UI animation, micro animation, very custom. There's so many of them, but they're all very, very well put together by talented designers and web engineers. Despite not all of them are UX related, but the presentation and the visual are definitely something that you can learn a thing or two from. When you browse a lot of those websites and get a lot of those images in your head, you will subconsciously set a standard of that visual design bar. Then when you iterate on your portfolio, you will subconsciously compare your design to those great visual design. And then slowly you will see, maybe this is off, maybe that is off. And then over time, you're going to polish your portfolio to the point that you'll get a similar feel to what you have in your subconscious mind. And all these should be very instinctual. It's part of your instinct, part of your designer instinct, designer sense. There are so many to look at, but if you want to have more portfolio-oriented, personal portfolio, agency portfolio, you can hop over to the menu and then collections. And scroll a little bit, you should see freelance portfolios. Then you have a very good pool of portfolios that you can compare yours directly to. Source number 2, designer portfolios from LinkedIn. This one is a little bit more involved because you have to go into a particular designer LinkedIn profile and find a portfolio link if they actually included it there. The bright side is any portfolio that you find has the validation from the industry because they're designers who are working in the industry already. So you can see what they have, how they present a project, how's their visual, compare what they have to what you have, see what yours is missing, then everything should become very straightforward. Just fill in the gap, fill in the void. If you want to hone into specifics, LinkedIn design portfolios are a great source for that. Because if you know your dream team, then find out which designers work on that team. Look for their portfolio. Once you gather all those portfolios, then you will know where the bar is. And next, you can just very effectively and efficiently iterate on your portfolio to match that level. Next one, Bestfolios. So this website actually have a lot of very good, very cool, interesting things you can look at. You can see portfolios from professional designers, those who work at Google, Facebook, Uber. This is very convenient because if you want to work at Google, then you go to the Google section and look at all the portfolios from the Google designers. Don't get me wrong, and don't just look at the Google designer portfolios. There are other good portfolios to look at too. The flip side, it does not have all the companies, but there are a lot of them in there. If we move one level lower, if you're a student and you want to intern at Google, again, then you can look for Google Interns Portfolios, as easy as that. Source number 4, company websites. I know I mentioned this in almost every other video, but it's still very true. I still have to emphasize this. Company websites are a great example of portfolios. Because the thing about it, these websites are designed by designers. Designers got hired to do those design, which means those website is a portfolio piece for those designers. For example, Apple.com, there's a whole interactive design team under Marcom to work on it. So Apple.com is designed by Apple designers, so it has to be a great example. Look carefully how they present a project, a product, a design features, how many images that they use, what angle is this shot? Do they crop the phone markup in order to highlight a particular feature or aspect in that design? Do they use an iPhone markup in every feature or just some of those? There are so many details, subtle details to study and to learn from. All it takes is a few minutes every day. Grab a cup of coffee, sit down, scroll through slowly. Think about why they do the way they do. Think about whether the presentation style will work on your own project. If it's very similar, if it makes sense, you can totally borrow a thing or two from their presentation. Number five, last one, Behance. Maybe it's a cliche, maybe not, but I have to drop it here. Behance is another site that have a mix of both professional and student work. To save you time searching for good ones or swimming in this pool of portfolios, you can go straight to UI UX, and then anything featured in the UI with this little tag or bookmark or award is great. If it has more than that, like a featured in Behance, even better. Because again, validation. These tags, these bookmarks, this award label, whatever they call that, somebody reviewed these. Somebody approved these, somebody think these are great examples. What I found useful in the past is to make my portfolio good, I need to know what good is, right? I need to know the standard, I need to know where the line is. Once I know what is good, then I can tell my portfolio is definitely not there, because when I compare the two, something is definitely missing. There's a gap. That's when I can learn something from it and get some inspirations on the good portfolios and apply them to my own. So what do you guys think? Does that help? Does everything make sense? Those are portfolio sources with really good UI or web design. More importantly, pay attention to all those visual details and think why they do what they do. That should give you a lot of light bulbs and so that you will know exactly what to iterate next. Final tip for junior designers, if you don't think you have a good grip of crafting good visual design yet, then you will need at least 10 to 20 hours immersing yourself in those good portfolios that I showed above to really have that visual design standard imprinted in your mind. Well, at least that's how I learned in the past. And I think it worked. Whew, a lot of heavy content, isn't it? Why not let's do something lighthearted? Let's go through some comments. First up, J12DNUX. Yeah, thanks, man. Glad to help. Thanks, Kelvin, my longtime, very supportive audience member. Yeah, glad that you like the editing. Last one, thank you, Cindy. I'm glad that your coffee breaks are fun. Yes, this episode is part of the UX portfolio series. So yes, there is a bonus content.
Bonus content.
I'm more than happy to take a look at your portfolio and give you some visual design focus feedback just for the sake of the content or the main subject of this video. All you have to do is one, smash the like button down below to help support me spending hours making this video. And two, let me know in the comment section down below that you have liked the video. And then you can send your portfolio link to my email, which you can find on the about page in my channel. Make sure to include a YouTube username so that I know you left that comment. And then I will take a look at your portfolio, give you some feedback on visual design, and give you a shout out in your next video. Good luck to you all on your next portfolio iteration, future internships, and full-time jobs. That's it for today. Thank you guys for watching. If you find this video useful and insightful, please go ahead and destroy the like button for the YouTube algorithm. This is still a small channel, so every like counts, and I would really appreciate it. If you want to see more UX design videos like this, also consider smash the subscribe button as well. Doing so will tremendously help the channel and motivate me to produce more high-quality content down the road. Have fun following your passion and keep designing a better future. See you on the next video. Tschüss!